I'm here with Jerry Hoffman. We're in the press room at the arena where Andre Ward is going to take on Chad Dawson. Jerry, introduce everybody to your website. Where could they find you?
12sportsonline.com. I've been doing video blogs just like you, Ali, for a long time.
But I'm sure you're much more knowledgeable than me about the sport of boxing. So first of all, break down the fight tonight, Ward Dawson.
Well, I doubt that, for one. For another, I mean, we've got a couple of guys that are strategic. They're thinking men out there. They are not big punchers. I look for the fight to go the distance. I think Andre will find a way to win most of the rounds and will retain his title.
And what do you think about the undercard, John Molina Jr.?
I love it. I love it. I think John Molina's jumping up a little bit too fast, too far. But he has a puncher's chance to shock the world. He is motivated. He had an issue with Goosen Tudor, and now he's back with them. I think that the stars might be aligned for him. But DeMarco's a better fighter. But anything can happen, Nelly. This is boxing.
There's another fight tonight with the Klitschko.
What do you think about that one? You know what? I'm not thinking much about that. All I can think of is that one day Seth Mitchell is going to get a chance to fight either Klitschko if they don't retire beforehand. I'd love to see that. I do believe that Seth is going to be the next American heavyweight champion of the world, whether it's next year or the year after. He's learning on the job, but he's my choice.
How many years have you been covering boxing, Jim?
Probably close to 30, if you consider the ring announcing that I did in the 80s and learned the business that way, and then all of the Riot at the Hyatts in Monterey that I put on, and the Shakedown and Quakedowns in Santa Cruz. I had a good run for 15 years, and I guess the economy got me for a while, but you never know, I might get going again.
Where is the state of boxing today? We're just a week away. We have two major cards on two different networks with... people say boxing is fading out, but when you have two networks putting on two major shows on the same night, it kind of shows that boxing is relevant.
It's definitely relevant with fights like tonight, the best fighting the best, Ellie. That's the name of the game, and we need to have promoters working with each other like Sean Goosen are doing, as opposed to what Golden Boy and Top Rank are doing. We'll find better fights. The sport will be healthier if people can work together. But, you know, heretofore, that hasn't happened. There's too much demand to dominate both ends of a main event, and that cannot be.
My last question, who's the best fighter in the world today, according to Jerry Hoffman?
You know what? That's a tough question. I mean, can I give you three?
Sure.
You know, I got to believe Andre Ward is in the top three. I love Nonito Donaire. And, you know, people may take offense to this, but I think if you gave Robert Guerrero a chance, he'd be up there too. He needs to fight guys that are the names that he's calling out. He's not getting those fights. I don't know if that's Golden Boy's fault or what, but I'd put him up there. I think that Pacquiao and Mayweather are long in the tooth. I want the young guys to get their opportunities. And that would be my top three, but bear in mind, they're all Northern California in my backyard, Ellie, so that's what I got to go with.
You're keeping it real. You're being loyal.
There you go.
So there you have it, Jerry Hoffman. Look out for him for usmusicborn.com. I'm Melissa Beck reporting. Yeah.